Cebu City Mayor Edgardo Labella died earlier this morning. He was 70 years old. Vice Mayor Michael Rama confirmed the news on ABS-CBN's Teleradio, adding he will be taking over the post. Labella's family earlier said that the mayor was hospitalized due to pneumonia. Prior to that, Labella had suffered from prostate cancer in 2009, but was cleared after an operation. His series of absences this year started on January 21st, when he had an ear infection that led to sepsis.
The Philippine Election Commission gives former Senator Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. more time to answer a petition seeking to block his presidential candidacy. Marcos now has until next week to respond to one out of five petitions filed against him. But the extension is being questioned by the petitioners. They say they will raise an objection to the COMELEC. This development comes just as the dictator's son brings in legal powerhouse attorney Estelito Mendoza as one of his lawyers.
It is really unusual, not to say the least. And what is even more unusual is that the lawyer of Marcos, Estelito Mendoza, knew about the extension even before the lawyer of the first group of petitioners was informed, and even before even the spokesperson of the COMELEC knew about it. He has a reputation of winning his cases. But he has also the reputation for, you know, doing all sorts of shenanigans to be able to win the cases.
The Marcos camp again brushing off the petitions as political propaganda.
Yung nagna number one sa ilang survey na ang lumalabas, ayaw nilang labanan sa fair and square fight. Hindi naman talaga kaso ito. Ang tawag nga namin dito ay nuisance petition o mga basurang petition na ibinubuhos sa Commission on Election.
President Duterte accuses one of the 2022 presidential contenders of being an illegal drug user. He did not reveal who it was, but he did drop a lot of hints. In a speech before anti-insurgency leaders in Oriental Mindoro, Duterte questioned that candidate's qualifications, describing him as a weak leader who's only popular because of his last name.
Bakit ang Pilipino parang lukong-luko na supporting? Magtanong lang ako sa inyo, ano ang ginawa niyan? Nagdadroga yan ng cocaine ang tirada niya. And he is a very weak leader, ang karakter niya. Except for the name. Pero ang tatay, pero siya, anong ginawa niya? He may make twin hands down. Okay. If that is what the Filipino wants, go ahead.
President Duterte also explained why he's running for senator next year. He says he intends to teach senators the proper way to conduct legislative inquiries if he wins a Senate seat himself. Duterte has repeatedly condemned a Senate probe into his administration's pandemic spending. He has barred cabinet officials from attending the Senate hearings, insisting these prevent them from performing their duties.
Paupuin mo ng ilang araw, tapos walang nangyari. Binabastos mo yung tao. You know, when you do that, you issue several summons, and you can only dispose one subject matter in for one witness. Hindi maganda. Kaya ako tatakbo. Kaya ako pag mag-ano, sabihin ko sila na, you know, there are rules in the Congress, but there are fundamental laws.
A pandemic task force official in the Philippines refutes claims he has joined the campaign team of presidential bet Manila Mayor Francisco Esco Moreno Dumagoso. The government's so-called testing czar, Vince Dizon, insists he is not involved in anyone's election campaign. Dizon says he remains focused on the national government's overall COVID response and recovery and not on politics. His statement contradicts an earlier claim by Moreno's campaign manager, Dito Banayo, that Dizon will eventually join them.
We fully respect the intent of Secretary Vince Dizon to meanwhile assist Secretary Carlito Galvez in the IATF vaccination drive. But we also will welcome Secretary Dizon into our campaign team when we have reached population immunity. I constantly sought his advice, and so did Mayor Isko Moreno, sought his advice. And we consulted him on a lot of matters, especially on surveys, on research design, and focus group discussions.